bring in Robert Henneke, the executive director of the Texas Public Policy Foundation. He joins us now. Robert, how can any member of the Biden administration, who is responsible for this horrific border policy, who may themselves also be a parent, how can that person sleep at night knowing this is being done to children?
Good morning. It's horrifying. 150,000 minor illegal immigrant children that have disappeared into this country into what is a modern slavery ring being facilitated by the Biden administration's trafficking of these children across the country to individuals, as your article mentioned, who some are criminals, and nobody knows what's happening to these children. It's the Biden administration. Look, it's the co-chair of the Biden campaign, Texas Congresswoman Veronica Escobar, who represents El Paso, that may want to call home and inquire as to what's happening in her district with these migrant children that are being literally sold into slavery and human trafficking across the United States.
You know, the video we were just watching there at the edge of that water, I believe that was a 1.5 or 2-year-old that was dropped off at the edge of that water, right there circled, and a Border Patrol agent, thank God, runs to save that little child. So it's not only dangerous when they get here, but it's dangerous getting here. And I think that really speaks volumes. Did you see the cartel member just run off? So when you see stuff like this, I mean, controversy just keeps piling up on this administration. And, you know, regardless of the timing, no timing is good when you see stuff like this going on and you hear reports like this from whistleblowers. My question is, will the Biden administration ever start talking about it? Because I think Americans deserve to hear directly from the president about all of these controversies and these crises just piling up on them.
They deserve those answers. And this is the record that Joe Biden will have to run on as he has just recently reannounced his election for president. It's horrifying. It's awful. Awful is too mild a word to describe what happened to these children in the hands of the cartel members, in the hands of the traffickers, what it takes to get to this country, that one happens to them once they're literally just dumped off on the side of the United States and then delivered by these nonprofit NGOs to individuals who would not pass the normal kind of background checks that you would have for a typical child protective services type foster care relationship. I think the states need to step in, need to take control of these children, and really make sure that where these nearly 750,000 children have been deposited into our country, we do our humanitarian duty to take care of them and to make sure that they are not abused and exploited.
The Biden administration has reportedly been unable to make contact with 85,000 of these children. Think about that for a moment. Meantime, you did mention the president launched his re-election bid yesterday. Here's what he did talk about in his first public remarks after that announcement.
Our economic plan is working. We now have to finish the job, but there's more to do. The threat the MAGA Republicans pose is to take us to a place we've never been. They'd rather see kids and seniors struggle to eat what they need. People on Medicaid lose their health care. Same old trickle down dressed up in MAGA clothing. Only worse.
Let's go to the beginning part of that statement. He said it's time to finish the job. Robert, if he does finish the job, can America recover?
It's an implicit threat. Finish the job of finishing off America. Joe Biden has announced his reelection effort. So let's talk about his record. Let's talk about during his presidency, we have record high inflation, that we have high energy prices, that we have this border crisis, that we have our international affairs in shambles as the United States relationship with China and Russia is all-time low. We've lost two embassies under this presidency. Let's talk about the fact that Joe Biden's cabinet is a disgrace, with the Department of Justice being corrupt and Homeland Security being inept. This is the record we should talk about, the performance of Joe Biden over the last 4 years. And it's going to be a lead weight around the neck. of every Democrat running for re-election in 2024.
Yeah, I mean, not to mention his speech was yet again divisive. He's constantly using the term MAGA extremist, MAGA Republican, just throwing that out there, gaslighting Americans who may not like Donald Trump. But you got to remember, 50% of America essentially voted for Donald Trump. Meantime, let's turn to this. Dr. Anthony Fauci giving a fascinating interview to the New York Times about the pandemic, saying, quote, show me a school that I shut down and show me a factory that I shut down. Never. I never did. I gave a public health recommendation that echoed the CDC's recommendation, and people made a decision based on that. Any shock he is kind of just washing his hands and stepping away from this?
It's no surprise that Fauci and those that were responsible for the COVID pandemic lockdowns want to wash their hands and whitewash history that occurred here. But the blame falls squarely upon the so-called health professionals and bureaucrats that closed schools, closed churches, ruined lives, closed businesses. We have to remember as Americans what was done in the so-called name of science that has been dispelled, what we've learned about the truth, about the misinformation that was being given by the government. And we have to guarantee that these kind of abuses that were led by Dr. Fauci never again happen to Americans or to our civil liberties.
He's never going to apologize. Robert Henneke, thank you so much for your insight.